What's up, y'all? What's going on? It's your boy, Minister Bernard Marrow. I pray that you've all had a blessed, great weekend and that you are excited and ready to press forward in this new week by faith. Y'all already know it's Monday. It's another beautiful, blessed Monday that God, the only true living God, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, has truly blessed us to see. It's another beautiful, blessed week that we are truly blessed, always being blessed, to press forward in by faith. Let's get into it. Check it out, family. Monday motivational moment. Make the decision to live your life for Christ, because the best life to live is a life lived for Jesus Christ. Make the decision to live your life for Christ, because the best life to live is a life lived for Jesus Christ. Family, I want to share with you all Romans chapter 12 and verse 2 in the King James Version. And the word of the Lord says, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable, perfect will of God." Family, I also want to share with you all 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 14 and 15 in the New Living Translation. And the word of the Lord says, "Either way, Christ's love controls us. Since we believe that Christ died for all, we also believe that we have all died to our old life. He died for everyone so that those who receive his new life will no longer live for themselves. Instead, they will live for Christ who died and was raised for them." And so check it out, family. When you let go of small thinking and you stop putting limits on God, you open up your life to your dreams and the fullness of God's blessings. Once that happens, you find yourself no longer conforming to the patterns of this world, but to the will of God. God wants to equip and empower you for your next level in Him. Paul basically described Jesus' role as our death substitute. Jesus died in the place of humanity to pay for each of our sins. Jesus, through His death, provides forgiveness of sins for those who put their faith and trust in Him. Jesus bled and died for the sake of sinners and was raised back to life by God. Paul expressed that he was compelled, controlled, and obligated by the love of Jesus Christ to keep delivering this message to more and more people. And so the message here is that eternal salvation is not just a single solitary purpose behind Jesus' death. Jesus also died and was raised back to life for those who put their faith and trust in Him for salvation, to stop living for themselves and begin to live for God. And so, family, I want to encourage you all, don't worry about who judge and talk about you. Now is the time for your life to change for the better. Allow the Holy Spirit to have His way in your life. Know that you can have a good, fun life living for Jesus Christ too. Having a good, fun life doesn't always mean living under the influence of drugs and alcohol. You can live for Jesus Christ and still have a blessed, good, fun life. Know that everything that God adds to your life is for your good. Everything that God adds to your life is for your benefit and your betterment. Everything that God adds to your life is for you to be healthy and to prosper. Everything that God adds to your life and to your gifts is for you to use to add value to this world. Family, choose to live your life for the Lord, a life of purpose and fulfillment. Take ownership and love the life you live, because the best life to live is a life lived for Jesus Christ. Let Jesus lead you. Stay focused and always press forward by faith. You already know, by faith we good, for we walk by faith and not by sight. I love you, family. God bless you and enjoy your week. I'm out.